Let's go!
Sounds pretty real.
I used to eat tacos every single day, but then I had a pizza slice and it blew me away.
Good morning, pizza lovers. It's Tuesday, the 26th of April. It is the 159th day of school. Wherever you may be, please stop and stand. Let us rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. It's been a minute. I'm going to invite you to join me today to keep this routine because it's good for you. Let's do 12 today. Join me. One, two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I like the number 12 because it's divisible by so many things, right? It's divisible by 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. So you can make groups in your classroom if you have 12 students. You can just make so many different configurations. For today, what's going on? Well, first of all, it's this Tuesday, which means it's COVID pool testing. We've got just a handful more of these to go. About 5 or 6 more times we're going to be COVID pool testing. Thank you for doing your part and for continuing to mask up in certain situations, maybe all situations. We have the option now of doing that, and things luckily have been safe enough that we're able to have such an option. So please keep doing your part. Coming up this week, tomorrow, our school district will be interviewing collectively the superintendent candidates. That's like the boss of the boss of the bosses. So in other words, the new boss of the entire school district, there's going to be one of only 3 people who are currently being considered. And we have a representative, Maria, in 7th grade, is going to represent us, Emerson School, with a student perspective. And she's going to go tomorrow night, and I'll be there. I hope some of you decide to come down there too to meet these 3 candidates so that we can make the best possible choice for our school and for our school district. I said in the WAG the wrong time, so it's actually tomorrow night from 6 until 8 o'clock p.m. at Herrera School for Performing Arts. Come and join us. We hope that you do. Then on Thursday, check this out. On Thursday, we are going to be hosting here a living history, an oral history and living history museum, as well as school participatory budgeting. That means there's 2 events for the price of 1. That means from 4 until 6 on Thursday evening of this week, you can come and be a part of Emerson history. Come and see the traditions, the oral traditions and histories that have been passed down, what these 7th and 8th grade students have been working on since October of this school year. Those will be on display for all to enjoy and to see. I think it will be a good time. I'm still curious to see where this zombie apocalypse comes from, but that's going to be great. And then come and vote, because we have a sum of money that we're going to be spending to renovate the courtyard in the 7th and 8th grade portion of our building. And they've opened it up to voting. So if you qualify for who gets to cast a vote, you'll be able to cast a vote tomorrow. And however the votes fall out on one of their several proposals, we'll actually spend the money in that way. It's pretty cool if you think about it. A sum of money was given to students. Students came up with multiple proposals on how to spend it. And then they decided who the voters would be, who gets to vote and who doesn't. And then of all those that vote, however that comes out, we spend the money in that way. It's a form of direct democracy, and that's pretty cool. So thank you to all the students who have participated in school participatory budgeting, and to all of you 7th and 8th graders who have participated and contributed to our living history and the gallery museum that's going to be done here tomorrow night. Come check it out. Then Friday morning, please come and join us, or invite your parents, rather, to come and join me for the Principal's Cafecito here at Emerson from 8:30 until 9. It's just a half hour, but it'll be the first time in, in 2 years that we'll be able to have a cafecito for parents and guardians here on campus in the same space together. So please be sure that they're aware of it. And then lastly, if you haven't already signed up, students, you can come and be a part of Emerson's summer camps if you're an incoming first through eighth grader. So eighth graders who are on your way to high school, I would encourage to attend the Freshman Academy. It's really good for you, and you actually get a half credit towards graduation. So you can actually start working towards graduation right away, and it's gonna make your high school experience so much better. I promise you, I encourage you, do that. For those of you in all the other grades though, please sign up for Emerson Summer Camp. There's only 60 spots for the first session and only 60 spots for the second session. But we're gonna be doing gardening and mural painting. If I can work it out, we're gonna be doing swimming. We're gonna be doing math in our gardens. We're gonna be doing STEM exercises, Phoenix Youth Circus Arts, media arts and illustration, design, lots of things to keep you active and engaged this summer for the entire month of June. So sign up, ask your parents about it. It's on Dojo, it's on Dojo, it's on Dojo. So that's where you should go to register and do it as quickly as you can, because when the 60 spots are filled, they're filled. All right, with that, let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning as we wind down these last couple of days in Autism Awareness Month. Today is on the topic of nonviolence. We live in a violent world, people physically hurting other people. You know what's going on, of course, in Ukraine, for example. Young people are hospitalized or die every day as a result of violence. It happens here too, on a smaller scale. Perhaps you've been touched by violence, or maybe you know someone who has. Pope John Paul had these words to say to individuals who act violently. Violence is cruel and leads nowhere. No good comes from adding to its growth. Look for ways to talk things out instead of using violence. His plea is for us to talk with each other about the things that bother us all, instead of being violent and hurting one another. If something's upsetting you, or you feel you're angry enough to hurt someone, talk to someone you trust. It could be a teacher, a counselor, Ms. Robbins, our social worker. Maybe it's a parent or guardian. Maybe it's a spiritual leader. Look for a way to talk through a problem. One last reminder before we sign off. The song that you heard today was All I Eat Is Pizza by Cuckoo Kangaroo, and is dedicated to Ms. Brown's class because she simply says, "We like this song." I've never heard that, but I like that song too. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today. In situations that are appropriate for you, please keep your distance, with or without a mask. Stay in your zones, put away your phones, and make it a great day or not. Choice is yours. All right, eat pizza now.